Today we are going to talk about software processors. Learning outcomes, you can be able to define software processors and can be able to describe in detail what are the available software process models and can be able to compare software process models and you can be able to choose between them what's the best. What is this process model? It's an abstract representation of a process. It represents a description of a process from some particular perspective. Okay, these are the software process models: waterfall model, prototyping model, evolutionary model, spiral model, increment model, rapid application development. Finally, we are going to discuss about agile model. What is this waterfall model? Step by step, sequential manner, you are following steps. First, the requirement definition. You are identify the requirement and write down what is the requirement. System and software design. After gathering the requirement, you are going to design the requirement. Next is implementation and unit testing. The implementation means you are going to code the software. After that, the programmers are testing the software, that is unit testing. Integration and system testing is you are going to integrate all the part of the system and do the system testing. Finally, operation and maintenance, you are going to deliver the system and do the maintenance means based on the customer requirement changes, you are going to do the modification. Here, this is a repetitive process, one after the other. If you want to move to the previous step, you can move into previous steps. There are some problems with the waterfall model. What are these problems? The main drawback of the waterfall is difficult to accommodate change. That means that when the customers need a change in the waterfall, unable to accommodate changes in the customer need. And also this is very applicable when the requirement is well understood and no any changes. You know, today the business systems have stable, not having any stable requirements, always the requirements are changing. This is mostly suited for large systems. Okay, these are the development phases based on the waterfall model: communication, planning, modeling, construction, finally the deployment. Under the communication, you can find the project initiation, requirement gathering. Planning, you are going to estimate, schedule, tracking. Under the modeling, you have analysis, design. Construction, you are going to code it and test. Finally, the deployment, delivery, support, feedback. What is this incremental approach? Here you can see increment 1, increment 2, and then it goes to number of increments. Increment 1, you are following the steps and deliver the first increment. You are following the increments in the steps and deliver the second increment. What is this increment development? You are going to break down the software into increments. So, the each increment delivering part of the required functionality. In here, you are going to prioritize the requirements and highest priority requirements you are going to deliver in early stage. Once the development increment is started, the requirements are frozen. Later increments can continue to evolve. Okay, this is incremental development phases. Define outline requirement. You are going to assign requirements to increment. Design system architecture. Develop system increment. Validate increment. Integrate increment. Then again, you are going to validate the system. Finally, you are going to deliver the system. Okay, there are advantages of incremental development. Here the customer value can be delivered with each increment, so the functionality is available in early stage. Customer can see the functionality of the system. Early increments act as a prototype to help to identify the requirement. Then that requirement can be used in the later stage. Okay? And lower risk of overall project failure. Failure risk is very low. Highest priority system receive most testing in incremental software development. Next is rapid application development. Here the rapid application development, there are several teams. They are working with increments. With a short life cycle, 60 to 90, you can deliver the system. The RAD model, the rapid application development, it is an incremental software development process. With a short life cycle, you are going to deliver the system. If requirements are well understood and project is constrained, so you can use this rapid application development. This is very suitable for short time period. These are the processes of RAD model. The first is business modeling. What is this business modeling? You are going to gather the requirement, the business requirement. What are the functionality? Data modeling, then the information flow which you have identified, convert into data. That means what are the data objects? Process modeling, the data object defined in the data modeling are transformed into processes, like what are the functionality functions you are going to implement. Application generation, the RAD, you use 4GL or visual tools to generate the system using reusable components. Testing and turnover, new components you need to test and deliver the customer. What are the problems with RAD model? Here the RAD, you need to create set of teams. To create the set of teams, you need to have sufficient human resources. And also always the developers and customers need committed to the rapid activities. So if your system cannot modularize, like you are unable to identify the increments, you are unable to use RAD. So the RAD is not applicable when the technical risk is high, you cannot use RAD. The next is prototyping. Today the prototyping is using to gather the requirements. These are some phases of the prototype. You have the quick plan, modeling, quick design, construction of prototype, deployment, delivery of feedback, communication. What is this prototype? It's a small version of a system used to demonstrate the concepts. What you are going to develop, you can demonstrate to the customer, then you can get the feedback from the customers and you can modify. There are two techniques, throwaway prototyping and evolutionary prototyping. Here the throwaway evolution. The throwaway means you use a prototype to gather the requirements. After finalizing the requirement, you can throw away the prototype and you can develop the system from the beginning. Evolutionary prototype means you are use the prototype to gather the requirement, then you can change that prototype into the deliverable system. That is what the difference. Okay, let's see what is throw away prototyping. You are going to establish outline specification, develop the prototype, evaluate the prototype, specify the system. So, design and implementation, validate and deliver in the system. You are going to throw away the prototype from the beginning, you are delivering the system. The throw away prototyping, the objective is to understand the system requirement clearly, start the poorly understood requirement. When the requirements are clear, the system will be developed from the beginning. The model is suitable if the requirements are vague but stable. There are problems with throw away prototyping. Important features can be left out because after identifying the requirement, you throw away the prototype and develop from the beginning. And also no any legal contract between the customer and the contractor. So there may be many problems coming in between the contractor and the customer. Okay. And also you cannot test the non-functional requirements like reliability, robustness. You are unable to test those things using prototype. Next is evolutionary prototype. Develop an initial implementation. After finalizing the requirement, you are going to implement the prototype into the system. Develop abstract specification, build prototype system. You are going to evaluate the prototype system. So the system is adequate. If no, again you are going to change the system. If yes, you are delivering the system. Advantages, effort is not wasted. That means the prototype is going to be developed into the system. This is faster than the waterfall model. High level of user involvement from the start and technical or other problems can be able to identify like risk early stage. This is suitable for vague and unstable requirement. Okay, the next model is spiral model. Let's see what is spiral. It's like a spiral. Here, first you are going to plan. Under the planning, you are going to do estimation, scheduling, risk analysis. Modeling, analysis design, construction, coding and testing, deployment, delivery feedback, communication. Here, the risk analysis, that means you are going to, at the early stage, you are identifying the risk. The process is represented like spiral rather than the sequential activities like the waterfall. So, the each loop spiral, you have a phase. No any fixed phases here. The risk identify early and you can resolve the risk identified throughout the process. Okay, there are other process models. The first one is component-based development, formal method, AOSD, unified process. Let's see what is component-based development. It is the process to apply when the reuse is a development objective. Formal method, that means mathematical development, you can use formal method, AOSD, defining, specifying, designing and constructing, unified, this is a use case driven, architecture centric, iterative and incremental software development, which is aligned with UML, you already know what is UML, Unified Modeling Language. Okay, now we are going to discuss about unified process. What is this unified process? It is use case driven, architecture centric, iterative and incremental software development process model. What is this use case driven? You know what is use case? This is basically the use case are drawn to show what the functionality of the system, what the user need. Okay, you can be able to identify the customer view, how the customers are communicate. Architecture centric, emphasize important role of software architecture. You can understand what are the future changes, how you are going to reuse them. Okay. What is special about unified process? It is like identify the best features from the conventional software process model. Then integrate them like you are using the features of waterfall, unified and integrate them. Then use the best principles and practices of agile software development. This is special about unified process. Okay, let's see what is the history. Early 1990, the object-oriented approach coming for analysis and design. Then used the UML as a common tool for object-oriented analysis and design. So the UML and unified process are used together. There are five phases in unified process. Inception, elaboration, construction, transition, production. Okay, here you can see the five phases. Inception, elaboration, construction, transition, finally the production means you are going to release the software increment. Okay. Here let's see how the five phases go with the workflows. You can see the inception, the requirements are going with inception and elaboration. Analysis, the elaboration, design is with elaboration, construction, small part is going for transition, implementation, construction, the testing is construction and transition, finally the support is the production. Okay, first phase, inception phase. Here the inception means the customer communication and planning activity. You are going to identify the business requirement. You are going to draw the initial use case here, like including functions, features, actors, sequence of actions. Basic project plan is here. Then you have the initial architecture. What are the subsystem functions? How you are going to model them? Okay. Here you are going to plan how many increments and iterations you are going to do in this software development. Okay. So you can analyze the risk. Based on the risk schedule, you can verify the number of increments and iteration. Next is elaboration phase. Customer communication and major modeling activities is under the elaboration phase. Here there are five use cases based on the initial use case: use case model, analysis model, design model, implementation model, deployment model. Okay. So here you are going to implement executable architecture baseline, and you can do the planning, like review plan, whether you have planned it correctly. You can review risk, what are the deliverable days. If want, you can do modification here. The next is construction phase. Make each use case you are going to operate. Okay, all increment phase to be completed. You can develop the test cases for the accept test. What are the unit tests you are going to carry on, and integration activities you can decide here. Transition is like the beta testing. You know, beta testing is you are given the software to small number of people and test the model. You are going to gather the user requirement, the user feedback here. So if need errors, you can fix it. You can develop user manuals, installation procedures. And finally, you have the releasable product. The production phase, you are going to deploy that activities, carry out installation and user training. There are workflows, process areas. These workflows are over the unified processes. You can find these workflows. It is like set of tasks. The set of tasks are working products. These are some unified process working products: inception, elaboration, construction, and transition. You can read them and understand. I'm not going to discuss in detail what are inside the workflows. What is this increment? Increment is like scheduling strategy. After following set of steps, you are delivering some product. That is the increment. Okay. What is this iterative? That is a reworking. After following set of steps, then again you are coming to the start. Then again following the step. That is the iterative. Okay. So combination of both iterative development means combination of both incremental and iterative approach. So we are saying that unified process is a hybrid approach because it follows the incremental iterative manner. There are four phases: inception, elaboration, construction, transition. Six disciplines: business modeling, requirement analysis and design, like implementation, testing and deployment. This is how the iterative development, this is the iteration and how the disciplines goes with the phases. Okay. UP, we say use case driven. What is this use case driven? In the unified process, use cases are used to capture the functional requirements and define the container of iteration. So the each iteration takes set of use cases or the scenarios for the implementation. That is why we are saying that use case driven. Architecture centric, that means inside the unified process you are going to identify the architecture, what are the subsystems, how you are going to reuse them, any multiple architecture models or views. That is what the architecture centric. Here the risk focus, the UP is the risk focus, because you can be able to identify and address the critical risk in the project life cycle. Okay, so the greatest risk can be able to identify at the early stage and you can solve. Okay, how the resources involved in each phases? You can see the construction, the highest resources needed. Then for the transition, the inception, less resources. Okay, what is the key difference in the inception phase and the other phases? So you can see in the inception phase, no time box iteration. In a large project, iteration in the initial phase is 2. The smallest phase in the project is what is that? Inception phase. Okay, what is the goal of inception? The inception goal is to establish the justification, like what is the business case of the project and what is the core boundary, You can be able to identify the use case requirement and outline the candidate architectures. You can identify the risk and you can schedule it, and you can cost estimate. Elaboration phase, the objectives, you can capture the system requirement, unknown risk can be able to identify, establish and validate system architecture. How you are going to validate in architecture? You support key system functionality. So the deliverables, you have a plan here. Construction is the largest phase. So system features is implemented like short time box iteration. So in each iteration you have executable release. The transition, you have the final project for the users. You can gain feedback and user training here. There are different refinement of unified process, the agile unified process, the basic unified process. Likewise, there are refinements of unified process. Here you can read it. This is the history of the unified process. It came first in 1988, then it is how in 2006, OpenARM, it is the version in 2006. Okay, how it relations among different unified processors. So there are agile here, the streamlining process. You are going to simplify in each workflows, reduce the number of expected. Okay. For an example here, the RAP, it is after transition of new inception, the EUP after transition of production phase. Each refinement is having a change. Okay, what is the waterfall and unified process? The difference here, the waterfall, you have a phases and you are following the phases and achieving the software. Unified process, you have the phases are representing the business activities rather than the technical information. Okay, that's the difference. Okay, these are the summary of the unified process best practices. I'm not going to read them, you can read them and understand.